Hello students, how are you all? Hope that all are doing well. So welcome to our history classes. Let us start the class. My dear students, here we are moving to the next topic of third lesson, that is Khalji dynasty. Here we will learn about another dynasty, that is Khalji dynasty. Jalaluddin Firoz, he was the founder of Khalji dynasty. The Khalji dynasty was established by Jalaluddin Firoz in 1290. But in 1296, his nephew, what is the name of the nephew of Jalaluddin? Alauddin. His nephew killed Jalaluddin. Alauddin killed Jalaluddin and proclaimed or declared himself as the Sultan of Khalji dynasty. And now we will discuss about Alauddin Khalji's conquest, how he defeated the area. Alauddin Khalji, he was the ablest and the strongest ruler of the Khalji dynasty. One important area he conquered, that was Gujarat. He conquered Gujarat. It gave him access or entry to the seaport. It enabled foreign trade. He conquered Gujarat and it gave a chance to or chance or access or entry to the seaport. And through this port, Khalji imported horses for his army. He also defeated the kings of Ranthambore, Marwar, Mewar, and Malwa. And one interesting thing related to Alauddin Khalji, he attacked Chittoor. Chittoor was the capital of Mewar. Okay, he attacked Chittoor for what? For the beauty queen of Padmini. Padmini, the beautiful queen of Mewar's ruler Ratan Singh. For Padmini, he attacked Chittoor, the capital of Mewar. Okay, and the next part we can see that how Alauddin controlled or how he faced the Mongol threats. And before explaining about the Mongol threats, we have to discuss about an important person. Who is that? Malik Kafur. Malik Kafur was the commander of Alauddin. With the help of Malik Kafur, Alauddin defeated or conquered many parts of India. And for a brief period or for a short period, Alauddin ruled or controlled or defeated almost the all part of India with the help of Malik Kafur. Here we can see how Khalji stopped or faced Mongol attacks or Mongol threats. For that he made, for controlling the Mongolian attacks, he made new forts and repaired old forts. And his generals, they were very strong and capable also. They led the army and fought against Mongolians. This is how Khalji faced the Mongolian attacks. For defeating Mongolians, he made new forts and repaired old ones. At the same time, his generals, military commanders, they were very strong and efficient. And they led the army and fought against Mongolians. This is how Khalji faced the Mongolian attack. Here we can see that Alauddin's policies and contribution. He was the first Delhi Sultan to maintain a large army. He was the first Delhi Sultan to maintain a well-equipped large army. And he paid his soldiers in cash. And now we can see his method of tax collection, how he collected tax from his people. Alauddin had land reassessed. And according to the land, he collected the tax. Those who have more land, he collected more money as tax. And he stored extra food item into his granary for meet natural crisis like famine and flood. Extra food item, he collected extra grains. He collected in his granary for the emergency situation. And he allowed in fixed the prices of all item, and cheating was severely punished in his time. And next paragraph we will see about his construction. He built a new city called Siri, and he made a reservoir called Hoskas, and he made madrasas also. Madrasa means it's a Muslim educational institution. He made a city, he made a reservoir, and he also added a madrasa. Okay, and here we can see one more person from his court. Who is that? Amir Khusru. Amir Khusru, he was a renowned scholar and musician also, and he was a member of Alauddin's court. Here we are going to discuss about another dynasty, that is Tughlaq dynasty. Tughlaq dynasty was started by Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq was the founder of Tughlaq dynasty in 1320. He was an efficient ruler. He suppressed, he defeated many attacks from the Mongolians. And after the death of Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq, his son Jona Khan took the charge of the dynasty, and later Jona Khan took their title Muhammad. He adopted a new name. Jona Khan adopted a new name, that is Muhammad bin Tughlaq. And we can know more about Muhammad bin Tughlaq through the writing of Ibn Battuta. Ibn Battuta, he was a North African traveler. Muhammad bin Tughlaq had good knowledge in various subjects, science, literature, etc. He changed the system of succession. What is the system of succession? After the death of a noble, his son should be the next noble or next ruler. Okay, at the time of Muhammad bin Tughlaq, he changed the system. According to the quality or talent, he given the rank. So nobles, they became enemies of Muhammad bin Tughlaq because he cancelled the policy of succession. The notable thing in his reign was he tried to implement many policies. He adopted new ideas, but it was not at all successful. Now here we will see that the wrong decisions taken by Tughlaq, Muhammad bin Tughlaq. First one is shift of capital. He shifted his capital. First it was in Delhi. Because of many Mongolian attacks, he changed his capital to Daulatabad. For that he made many roads. First he sent officials and nobles. But the journey, the long journey, it was very difficult for the common people. So again he shifted the capital back to Delhi. And this decision also caused heavy financial problem. This decision also led many financial crises. After shifting back to Delhi, the Sultan lost control over the Deccan. And next one, campaigns. The military campaigns organized by him made both money and life loss. Because it was not well planned, so it also was a failure. Muhammad bin Tughlaq planned a military campaign in Central Asia. But the absence of proper planning, this decision also went wrong. Okay, it was also a failure. Next one, taxation. After the shifting of capital, after the campaigning, the king, ही मीट द लॉस ऑफ मनी ड्यू टू द अबव रीजन्स ही इंक्रीज टैक्स इन फार्मर्स फॉर सॉल्विंग दिस फिनाशियल क्राइसिस ही इंक्रीज टैक्सेस ऑन फार्मर्स सो नेचुरली फार्मर्स दे वेर नॉट रेडी टू पे दिस अमाउंट ऑफ दैट मच अमाउंट ऑफ मनी एज टैक्स सो द फार्मर्स प्रोटेस्टेड अगेंस्ट द किंग द किंग ही वॉज वेरी पवरफुल ही डिफीटेड ही क्रश द प्रोटेस्ट But the farmers, they were not ready to cultivate any crop in their land. This led to famine. And to solve the famine means lack of food item. He supplied food grains from his granary for 6 months and gave loan to the cultivators. Loan to allotted many loans for the farmer. Here we will see the next step taken by Tughlaq, that is token currency. Tughlaq was impressed by the paper currency in China, so he introduced bronze coins equal to the silver coin. Why did he introduce bronze coin? Because to overcome the shortage of silver. To overcome a shortage of silver, he introduced bronze coin. It was also a wrong decision. When bronze coins became popular, people began to make duplicate coins. It led to a huge economic problem. Trade fell down, so he withdrawn bronze coin. So king withdrawn bronze coin. Why? When bronze coin became popular, people began to make duplicate coin. It led to huge economic problems. Okay, so the king he withdrew bronze coins and introduced gold coins. This was also a wrong decision taken by Tughlaq. His unsuccessful policy, Tughlaq's unsuccessful policies made a bad image among the people. In many places, revolts broke out and it led the division of kingdom into various small parts. He died in 1351. After an unsuccessful policy, he made a bad image among people. He made a bad image among people, so naturally in many places revolts broke out and it led to a division of king's kingdom and into various small parts. He died in 1351. Okay, and next part we will continue with the next class. Okay, up to here all of you read, and if you have any doubt about this topic, please comment. Okay, thank you.